I am at the Faenza Cylinder, and today you will see highly technological content, as well as something very new. The motor of a 4K laser projector will be replaced. You will see how this machine is built internally. It is not a larger home projector, as some people might think, but it features advanced technologies, specifically designed for cinema. Removal of the lens. This is the lens that will then be reassembled onto the new motor. Removal of the cover.
I am simply removing the partitions to then access the sealed compartment that is here, where the engine is located.
This is the machine.
A couple of barriers, and then the compartment is sealed because it needs to let in as little dust as possible. And this is the part that we need to change. The technology is the same. This has been redesigned compared to those that were on the lamp. It is a 4K chip with a diagonal of 0.98 inches, while the old 4K chips were wider at 1.38 inches. So they managed to fit more pixels into a smaller size. Let's start removing some cables. Now it has these cables, I don't remember the structure. No, is it the SATI or SCSI? No, it's SAT. They are much more comfortable compared to the 18 that were there in the old days. Now I only remove these three, liquid cooling. Sure, but the liquid should definitely not be changed. It is sealed. They use a different glycol. Make sure to buy that one because you need it. It hasn't arrived. Let's see where that damn throne goes. Let's see where it goes. In fact, you will never see the screw in the video, right?
No. Also because it's the one down there. This is a serious unboxing. Now let's discover the heart of our system. It's designed to protect a particularly sensitive piece. Here too. A metal box just for transporting it.
Yes, because it must be hyper-protected. If we put a cover on top, it could also look like a coffee machine. The motor arrived in a cardboard box inside another cardboard box, which in turn was covered by a completely metal lid, because all these parts could otherwise be damaged if they were in direct contact with the cardboard. Here there are tubes, cables, boards, liquid, and of course the laser source. The red, green, and blue modules are mixed inside the integrator rod and inside the light pipe. It becomes white light. It enters the engine, and in the middle there is a prism that separates the light into the three primary colors, red, green, and blue. And then it directs these three light beams onto what are called DMDs. These are small chips that have micro mirrors on them that rotate, and based on the rotation, they refract more or less light, creating various shades of color. So, red, green, blue, those various microspecs that then channel towards the output, towards the lens, which is here, and produces the image on the screen.
But is this the old engine?
This was installed last week on the new one, but it has a defect. Last week or 2 weeks ago, I don't remember. So we are going to change it and install the new motor. This is here. So those are the tubes for cooling. Inside, there is already the liquid in that piece of tube they provided, which comes pre-filled with water and glycol. It's antifreeze, mold resistant, and anti-aging. Now let's connect the data cables.
What type are these three cables?
They are SATA. They are essentially hard disk cables that they have used this time to make. Since they have sufficient bandwidth for the data they need, they usually use these for convenience. The old engines had three small cables instead of one, so there was a bit more to do.
So what do you connect those cables from the engine to?
The back plane, which is essentially a motherboard, is located here at the back and receives all these input cards. One of those is the server, which is responsible for where you load the films and is also the one that sends the necessary information to the engine to create the images. Then there is another board, the cinema controller, which manages the brain of the projector, managing communication between all the boards and communication between all the components of the projector. This is the part of the laser lighting. So, under all these modules you see, there are the various laser modules, red, green, and blue. Then there are interconnection boards that allow them to communicate with each other. Cooled by liquid, there is a collector above each module through which the water and cooling liquid enter and exit. On this side, however, there is only one, in this case because the machine requires only one. Inside here are the various control boards for the laser modules. This is a component that can be styled, opened, and even have just one board changed. On the slightly larger machines, there is another one like this next to it because there are more laser modules. If we're lucky, there is a two-line setup.
Thoughts?
Maybe we just probably did it.
Let's reassemble the lens. Reassemble the lens because I am not able to lens secured.
Here there is indeed a touchscreen that provides basic control of the projector. Although in reality, all control and configuration are done through a web page by connecting to it. This board here is called the cinema controller, which is the brain of the projector. And this board is the server, where films and their trailers are loaded. Then there are outputs that go to the audio processor, a cable for the lighting controls of the room, and communication cables for transferring content over the network. This is also the board that sends information to that piece we changed earlier to generate the image on the screen.
The machine is starting up, and the test has been successful. They are now making various adjustments, including focusing, masking, and ensuring everything is perfectly aligned.
This is a new milestone for Cinedream. Finally, in 2023, we will be able to implement the new machines with laser projection, which also includes subtitling. We are moving from 2K to 4K, thus achieving a higher definition. On screens like ours, which are not particularly large, 4K is less significant, but the laser has a very important performance, both in terms of energy efficiency and image quality. All the dark images, a bit difficult to see, can make us imagine a Batman rather than dark scenes inside galleries, work very well with the new machines.
It's amazing to see how much technology is inside this machine. There's a reason why the images here at Cinedream are so beautiful. It's wonderful to witness all the technological advancements, the evolution from digital film to 2K, 4K, and there will be many other improving technologies that we will see over the years. I want to thank Cinedream for giving us the opportunity to document how this video projection machine is made on the inside. We will create more content so you will discover more details about what is inside and behind the world of cinema. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel. Thank you. See you soon.